Hello, and welcome to another episode of the Machine Learning Essentials series. I'm Nishant Tucker, and in this video, we'll talk about hybrid and multi-cloud machine learning. Now, there are a lot of definitions for hybrid or multi-cloud machine learning. What we'll cover is how you can enable machine learning solutions to leverage your on-premises and third-party cloud infrastructure. But first, let's start with an understanding of why we need such a capability. Well, there could be a variety of reasons depending on what your domain is and use cases are. You may be on your journey to the cloud and not all your data is there yet, so you want to run machine learning on-premises. Or you're creating a solution for a highly regulated industry and need data to remain on-premises or on a sovereign or private cloud. You might already have data on other third-party clouds, and now you want to leverage the machine learning capabilities from Azure to enrich your solutions there. Alternately, if you want to utilize your unused compute infrastructure, either on-premises or on third-party clouds, and vice versa, to implement cloud burst scenarios, where you start small in your local environment, and now you want to expand to the cloud because you're running out of compute infrastructure in your local environments. Whatever be the reason, hybrid and multi-cloud deployments are becoming more and more the norm rather than an exception, and enterprises are looking for this capability to hedge their bets for the future. Let's take a deeper look at how Azure enables hybrid and multi-cloud machine learning deployments. There are two key concepts to understand. One, what are the considerations for hybrid and multi-cloud deployments? And two, how does such a deployment work? Let's look at each of these one by one. First, let's understand the considerations. When we think about deployments that span hybrid environments, we have to make some important choices about our solution architecture, especially around compute options and deployment topologies. The reason being, anything you choose needs to be available across your target environments. One such compute option is Kubernetes. It is available to be deployed on-premises and as a service on all public clouds. It also brings a well-understood and widely adopted deployment topology with containers. Machine learning has adopted the container topology to package the models and their dependencies so that these can be run anywhere. Here is a pro tip. Kubernetes clusters support both GPU and CPU compute options, enabling machine learning workloads to utilize the right compute options as needed. This makes Kubernetes a very good choice for hybrid and multi-cloud deployments. The other consideration is management, both at the infrastructure deployment level and the machine learning lifecycle management level. At the infra level, you need to ensure that it can seamlessly interact with the deployment targets, whether it is on-premises infrastructure or public cloud infrastructure like Azure, AWS, or GCP. This allows it to maintain the health of the deployments and assist with automation, tracking, security, etc. from a centralized management console. With Azure, this is made possible with Azure Arc. Azure Arc offers simplified management and faster deployment, and it helps standardize visibility, operations, and compliance across a wide range of resources and locations by extending the Azure control plane. Since it can ship and manage solutions from Azure to any Kubernetes distribution in any location, it enables you to securely build and train machine learning models anywhere. The other aspect that needs to be managed is the machine learning lifecycle. Again, you need a tool or a service that can run anywhere and provide a management plane for the end-to-end lifecycle. It also needs to integrate seamlessly with Kubernetes as an engine. With Azure, this is accomplished via Azure Machine Learning. Azure Machine Learning provides an SDK that can run anywhere, including on-premises and other public clouds, to provide that single lifecycle management service across all the deployment targets. Here's a pro tip. Azure Machine Learning also supports ML Flow so that even existing deployments can be configured to join Azure Machine Learning and enterprises can centralize the machine learning workflow entirely. Understandably, customers can now run and manage their machine learning training on Kubernetes clusters in Azure, GCP, AWS, edge devices, or even on-premises through Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes. This allows customers to increase operational efficiency. Now, you must be wondering, how does this work? Great question. Let's tackle it by looking at the two personas involved here. First, how administrators utilize the common Azure Arc plane and provide resources for data scientists. And second, how data scientists utilize these resources for distributed model training. Let's understand the administrator's job first. With a few clicks, administrators can enable the Azure Machine Learning Agent to run on any open source Kubernetes cluster that Azure Arc supports. This, along with other key design patterns, ensures a seamless setup of the agent on any open source Kubernetes cluster, such as AKS, Red Hat OpenShift, managed Kubernetes service from other cloud providers, etc. There are multiple benefits of this design, including using core Kubernetes concepts to set up or configure a cluster, running cloud-native tools such as GitOps, etc. Once the agent is successfully deployed, administrators can either grant data scientists access to the entire cluster or a slice of the cluster using native concepts such as namespaces, node selectors, tolerance, etc. The configuration and lifecycle management of the cluster, such as setting up auto-scaling, upgrading to new Kubernetes version, is all transparent, flexible, and continues to remain the responsibility of the IT operations team. Next, let's understand what the data scientist needs to do. Does the data scientist need to know Kubernetes? Not really. One of the core principles we adhered to was splitting the administrator persona and the data scientist one with separate roles and responsibilities. Data scientists do not need to know anything about or learn Kubernetes. To them, it is just another compute target that they can submit their training jobs to. Within Azure Machine Learning, they will be able to see this as an option for attached compute and just select the relevant Arc-enabled cluster as the compute option for training. This enables them to use familiar tools such as Jupyter Notebooks, TensorFlow, PyTorch, etc., and spend their time solving machine learning problems rather than managing the infrastructure that they are running on. Here's a pro tip. Do not expect data scientists to be able to understand and manage execution environments like Kubernetes. Their time is best utilized building and optimizing machine learning models. Now, Kubernetes comes with its own set of challenges around security, management, and governance. Azure Machine Learning and Azure Arc-enabled Kubernetes come together to ensure that not only is an administrator able to centrally monitor and apply policies on your workloads on Arc infrastructure, but also ensure that the interaction with Azure Machine Learning service is secure and compliant. This, along with a consistent experience across the cloud and on-premises clusters, no longer requires you to lift and shift machine learning workloads, but seamlessly operate them across both. You can choose to just run in the cloud to take advantage of the scale or just run on excess on-premises capacity while leveraging the single pane of glass Azure Arc provides to manage all your hybrid and multi-cloud infrastructure. Hope this gives you a good understanding of an enterprise-ready hybrid and multi-cloud machine learning deployment. To recap, we looked at two core concepts. The considerations: norming on an execution environment and management service that can be made available anywhere. And the solution: with Azure Arc and Azure Machine Learning, you enable both admins and data scientists to do their job to the fullest and achieve operational efficiencies. Well, that's it for this video. Hope this inspires you to think of innovative ways to utilize these hybrid and multi-cloud capabilities for machine learning. As always, to try these on Azure, please spin up a free Azure Machine Learning workspace at aka.ms/aml-trial and download the 30-day learning journey from the Data Scientist Resources page at aka.ms/data-scientists. See you in another episode of the Machine Learning Essentials.